Welcome to the first ever New Year's Eve countdown with Punch TV. We are very excited to have the Justice League here. You know, people aren't fighting, doing crimes and stuff so much on New Year's Eve. They're out having a good time with their friends and family. So these guys took the night off and are having a good time with us. And we hope that you guys have a good time with us too. So before we actually start the clock, I thought it would be kind of cool to find out what everybody liked about 2016 and what they're most looking forward to for 2017. So I'm going to head over here and ask this crew here, tell me, Spider-Man, what was your favorite thing about 2016?
Probably the one guy that was in the parking lot.
Oh yeah? Did you give him the what for?
Oh no.
What did he do in the parking lot? Was that like a valet or something? Was he doing a crime?
Yes.
And you arrested him?
Yes.
How much web does it take to, like, actually restrict somebody enough to keep them bound until the police come? Like, a lot? A couple seconds worth? How much web?
Probably 3 cartridges, because my webs perspire in half an hour, so...
Well, you know, you got the connections to get lots of that stuff, though, right?
Yeah, so it'd suck if I webbed somebody and then the cops on the other side of the city would come.
Well, yeah, but you're prepared. You're like that Boy Scout thing, right? You were in the Boy Scouts, so yeah, you're prepared. That's excellent. Okay, Doctor Strange, this was a huge year for you. Congratulations. Tell me a little bit about what you liked best about 2016 and what you're looking forward to the most in 2017.
Well, my movie came out this year.
I know.
So very exciting, and it made millions of dollars.
It did. And so what are you going to do with all that money?
Yeah, that's a good question. I'm looking at investments, but I'll let you know about that in 2017.
Okay, well, we'll have to have you back on the show so you can tell us about what you're going to reveal to the rest of the world.
Excellent.
Fabulous. Tony, you've got Batman and Thor over there, and
yes,
I'm very
do, yes.
curious about what they are up to for 2017 and what
right
they like about 2016.
Well, right now we're having the party. Hey, guys. Woo! We are partying hardy over here with Thor and Batman. Hey, Thor, how's it going?
Good, how are you doing?
I'm doing really good. And Batman, you look really, you know, moody.
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 Very moody.
All right. Well, there you go. We're just hanging out. What do you guys think? 2016's over. Do you have any, like, awesome things that you did? Crime? Fighting, per se?
I didn't seem to do a whole lot this year.
Nothing.
Didn't seem like it, no.
But your big thing is next year.
Yes, yes.
So you're waiting.
Oh, yeah. Yes, you're letting other people have the spotlight this year.
Yeah.
And then next year, I take it back.
And Batman, you were in 2 movies this year.
2?
Yeah. weren't you in 2 movies?
I starred in 2 movies.
But you were, how many other movies were you in?
Well, I was in lots of movies, yeah. But I starred in 2 of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Suicide
yeah.
Squad.
My movie. And Batman versus that other guy. My movie.
Yeah. Yeah. So, what was, okay, yeah. That's 2. Wait,
yeah.
That's 2. Isn't that 2? Am I
well,
missing
then
a movie?
There's the animated stuff too.
Oh,
right?
The animated.
I don't know, does that
yeah.
count?
Busy.
Yeah, that's a, yeah. Good.
Busy.
Well, hey, Batman. Well, good.
Yeah.
Yeah. You seem. I got to blow some more horns. Woo! Woo! Okay.
I love that. Usually Batman's so stoic to see cutting loose and actually having some fun is a very big deal for us for 2017. We're breaking
waiting.
In a new wave of mood for you.
We're waiting for the champagne,
okay,
Jody.
Yeah, we're going to pop that. We
champagne.
Are going to do some toasting here today. Craigers, tell us, what was your favorite movie of 2016?
Well, it's been a weak year, really. Hank,
of Doctor Strange.
Outside of Doctor Strange, of course, and all the movies that Batman was in and that Thor wasn't in. Hank and I were just talking about this, actually, but I probably would have to say, so far, maybe Arrival.
I thought that the aliens in Arrival were tremendous.
Yeah, it's more of a thinking person science fiction movie, but definitely was a surprise this year, so.
I hope we see more of that. I don't really like Amy Adams that much, but she was good. I was pleasantly surprised. No, Tony, we've had this conversation already.
It was the same,
she is not
right,
the girl
up until
from
I, yeah,
the
I
office.
Honestly thought it was the same woman.
Not
so.
At all. Okay, well, Supergirl, what was your favorite thing of 2016?
I think my favorite part of 2016 is whenever Batman's Batwing breaks down, I have to fly him to the location, and it brings him down a peg or two.
Wow, like that seems, like does this happen a lot?
It does actually, for some reason.
Wow. So you're a really good friend. Batman is like super lucky to have you in his life.
Right?
Right. Well, but I think that's true. The the Justice League, you guys, you know, you support each other and help each other as much as you can, right?
Yeah, we do. Yeah, we want to be there for each other.
Yes. That's a good lesson for all of us, that bonding community spirit, right? It's a good thing. Do you have something you want to say about that? Well, Batman, I hope that your vehicle woes disappear for 27 and that you have a lot more mechanical success in the new year.
Me too.
Awesome. Well, we're going to take a little break and we will come back with some tweet beat stuff because we haven't heard from Hank yet. He's been very quiet in the corner there and he's going to tell us all about the best of 2016 and what's coming up for 2017. And then Craig's going to teach us how to make a cocktail. And then we have a really special surprise for you that we've worked very hard on and we hope you really enjoy. So more after this break. With community enhancement as their goal, the Justice League of Saskatoon aims to bring smiles to the faces of young and old. Do you think you have what it takes to join this prestigious crew? The JLS is waiting for you. Visit their Facebook page, JLS Justice League of Saskatoon, for more information on how you can make our city a better place to be. Then grab your cape and fly.
Experience the wonder of the Enchanted Forest with the support of BHP Billiton, celebrating our 18th sparkling season and featuring the new Nutcracker light display. The Enchanted Forest is one of the most spectacular light shows in Canada. We are open from 5:30 to 10 p.m. every evening through January 7th at the Saskatoon Forestry Farm Park. For more information, go to enchanted-forest.org. Proceeds support the Saskatoon City Hospital Foundation and the Saskatoon Zoo Foundation.
During the holiday season, families gather to share joys, hopes, and traditions. Wishing your families peace, happy holidays, and a happy new year from the families of the Dragons Car Club. We hope to see you at our car show this spring.
Hello, lovely ladies and or dudes. My name is Hank, and with me right now, for the very first time on TweetBeat, it's...
Tony!
Hello!
That was awkward. Thanks for being here, Tony. And what some of you may or may not know is that Tony has been starting to update his look a little bit. As you see, he's got a sweater on tonight for New Year's. And I can't afford a suit. So hopefully this coming year, my New Year's resolution, earn some money and buy a suit so I can dress up. Anywho, right now on TweetBeat, which is what we're doing right now, we are going to be talking of the best ofs of 2016. And there is a disclaimer that as of this point right now, okay, these are the best ofs. Because in the future, in the next few weeks, I want to try and watch La La Land because I haven't had a chance to see it. Maybe that was going to be on there. You never know, okay?
Yeah, so this is stuff that you've seen up until
yes,
now.
Right now, okay? So don't get mad and you're like, how come you didn't put that on there? Well, so maybe I haven't watched it yet. I'm trying, okay?
Yeah.
So
This is hard. It's hard to keep up with Christmas.
It's hard. Yeah. And New Year's.
There's a lot of shopping going on, I noticed.
A lot of shopping. So speaking of the best ofs, let's talk about movies first. Tony, what do you think that your, even not the best, maybe just your favorite movie?
Well, I think anything Star Wars that comes out is my favorite.
So shocker!
Yeah, Rogue One is definitely my favorite movie. I thought the action was spectacular and just all out great acting, and I think it was a great movie, so yeah.
Well, I enjoyed it too, and I'm glad we could go together.
Yeah,
that was neat.
Yeah, we had a good time.
Yeah.
We even shared.
We did. It was cute. So the best movies, I've got a few written down here. Now we are talking that from me, Hank, okay? Not endorsed by Shaw TV, Saskatoon, or anybody else in the Punch crew, okay? These are just my picks, so don't get mad, okay? I've got an alphabetical order, to be fair. Arrival, did you see it?
Great, awesome, awesome movie. Loved Arrival, yes.
Loved Arrival, it's on there. Don't Think Twice.
No, don't think about that. I don't know what that is.
Great movie, you should watch it. And I'm sure as we're going through here, there's pictures of, the movie poster, so people know that we're talking. I don't know. Hell or High Water, awesome.
Yeah, it was really good. I really enjoyed that one.
Yes, you did. Bank Robbery, kind of more of a Western feel. Hunt for the Wilder People, because they're in the wild. An amazing film. We've got The Lobster. Not crabs. Lobster. Loving. Manchester by the Sea. Moonlight. The Nice Guys, and for an animated film, Zootopia.
Zootopia was good. Yeah, I think the animation was pretty good in Zootopia.
Who was your favorite character?
the crab.
You only saw him for a split second in the after credits. The crab was cute. Tony, do you watch TV?
I do watch TV, yes.
Do you have a favorite television show?
Right now I watch The Goldbergs. It would be my favorite television show. And what's Kim's Confectionery, I think it's called?
Ooh, on CBC.
Yeah, it's a great show, yes.
Represent CBC. Okay, we're going to whip through these fast. We're running out of time here. So Hanks picks The Americans on FX, Atlanta on FX, Billions on Showtime, which obviously is your favorite show, Fleabag, the funniest show on television on BBC Three. You can also see it on BBC America. High Maintenance on HBO. Horace and Pete, only available on louisck.net. Narcos on Netflix. The Path on Hulu. The Path, right? You're with me? You should watch it. Stranger Things on Netflix.
Yeah, Stranger Things is awesome. Woo!
You've watched that one.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I watched that one.
For something that I just discovered a little while ago, Superstore on NBC.
Oh.
Have you watched it?
No. Yes, I've seen the previews. No, I have no idea what you're talking about.
It is hilarious. It is an amazing television show that's on NBC of all networks. Veep on HBO, and of course, Westworld on HBO.
Westworld is definitely, I throw that in there, that is like a great show, and I'm really sad that it is over for this season because it was amazing and it was a great TV show.
Are you into comics like Criminal and anything that Brubaker and Phillips rock out?
Not really, no.
Oh,
not really.
Because Ed was writing some of Westworld. So
I saw that, and I thought it might be horrible because he was, but it was good. He actually did a good job there.
Amazing. And now we're going to say that we are about out of time here on Tweet Beat. So again, I'm Hank. This is Tony.
Tony.
And coming up soon are the 2017 Hanky Awards. Of course, you can find that at Hank and Kelso and at Shaw Punch TV, so you can find out more about video games, comic books, and all the things that we didn't cover right now. So see you next time on Tweet Beat.
Collector!
Traitor.
All right. Well, those were some awesome suggestions and predictions from Hank. And now we have Craig's going to teach us a little bit about mixology. Our superhero crew got called away to a critical situation. So there is still some crime happening. Commissioner Gordon called up and called them away, which is probably good to get the children out of here because we're going to make an alcoholic beverage. Mmm, it's a good kind. So, Craigers, tell us a little bit about what you're going to mix up for me today.
Okay, well, I'm going to make an old-fashioned, which is obviously anybody that watches Mad Men would know that it's Don Draper's drink of choice. And in fact, I think Mad Men really precipitated the rise of the old-fashioned again in popular culture and even classic cocktails. So it's a pretty easy drink to make. It's got the perfect mix of booziness but sweetness too. So it's just great. It was I'll start by taking some here.
Okay.
Some sugar. So you need about a spoonful of sugar to help the medicine go down.
I love that, like the booze that are in all the Mad Men, like they're well equipped, you know, they've got some good variety, but like they would have all of this stuff. So like beside your desk, you're gonna have some stuff for making simple syrup and bitters and some orange peel and all this other good stuff that it seems like you've got to make a pretty involved cocktail.
Yeah, so I took the sugar and I added also a spoonful of water to it, and now I'm muddling it, as they call it. I'm just using a spoon. You can get a muddling set if you want. So you muddle that up so you have what you just called a simple syrup, which is basically water and sugar, really. Muddle that up real good. Then you take these bitters. They're called Angostura bitters, which is sort of a bark of a tree they're made from. And they just give it a little bit of flavor and a little bit of aroma. They're very aromatic. So you...
What's your take on all the new bitters? Sorry to interrupt, but like there seems to be a lot of like artisan style bitters on the market. Are they any good, or is it best to just stick with the classic?
Well, I mean, for most classic cocktails, you'll find sort of the Angostura ones, but you can get all kinds of different ones, orange or, you know, other different flavors. Depends what kind of cocktail you're making, because different cocktails can call for a different set of flavors. So if you need a little orange essence in something, then those work really well too. So we'll just muddle that in as well. Then we take the bourbon And we add...
Does it matter? Whoa, that is a lot of bourbon. Do you have a favorite bourbon?
I like this one, actually. It's called Bullet Bourbon.
Okay.
And so two shots. It's a pretty stiff drink. Or you can go a shot and a half if you're, trying to be more careful. So this drink, I think, was... I don't know if it was invented, but it sort of came to prominence at a place called the Penn Dennis Club in Louisville, Kentucky, in the late 1800s. And it was named for a famous party for a bourbon distiller that was sort of prominent at the time. So,
it looks pretty. The color is gorgeous.
Yeah, it's good. And so we'll take we've got a Borg cube or BB-8.
Okay, so if you've ever watched the show, you know that I collect molds for things because we've made chocolates and stuff. So I got a BB-8 one for Christmas, and he's so cute when he comes out. This one's a little bit melty, so you can't really see the details as well. But I also got this Borg one. I'm not a huge Star Trek fan, but it's like, it's a mold, so I gotta have it, right? That's that collector mentality. But they actually work really good. You like put them together, you fill them in through the little hole, you stick them in the freezer, and then this just pops open like that, and it has lots of little detail on the inside. So they're good. They're fun little party favors.
Yeah, I have a Death Star one at home. Actually, I think I have some R2-D2 ones, too.
Ooh, yeah, I've got the R2-D2. I find the feet always break off, though, when you take them out of the mold.
Yeah, they look more fun in the store than they do sometimes in the ice cube. So now I have added the BB-8 ice cube, and so the final thing is a garnish, and it's just a piece of orange peel. Gives it just, again, that little more essence of flavor. You will see in some restaurants people add maraschino cherries and all kinds of other stuff. That is not the classic old-fashioned. If you're making a classic old-fashioned, the only garnish is the orange peel. Popper in there. I usually give it a little stir to mix things up. And
all right. Oh, it's so pretty. It smells really good. And I do think that the orange adds a little bit too. So I'm going to drink this off camera. It's a little boozy and beautiful. And while I do that, you can enjoy the fruits of our labors. We have made a fabulous video for you that I think you're really going to enjoy that I think says everything that we want to say about 2016. So here you go. Enjoy. Cheers.
We're pasty basement dwellers, pop culture Rockefellers. It's 2016's final frontier, so have a nerdy new year.
On the tweet beat, Tony's the collector, Craig's the movie geek, and Jody brings us all together. 2016, you couldn't last. Seems like things go by so fast. Pokemon Go's already Pokemon gone. It's upside down like a demigorgon. Kardashian's phony jewelry heist
made it into our zeitgeist.
Down in the States, things aren't so good. Trump's moving into a worse neighborhood. To list bigger than Denny's biggest breakfast, but we gotta give shout outs to Bowie and Prince
and Willy Wonka's finally got his golden tickets.
Cohen, Lemmy, Snape and Ali,
R2-D2
and Mr. Hockey. Man, it's so sad, but it's dark before dawn and we got more important things to nerd on.
We're pasty basement dwellers, pop culture Rockefellers. 2016's final frontier, so have a nerdy new year.
Don't care much for world affairs and news. 2016 fed a pop culture muse. Luke Cage and Netflix are bulletproof. Preacher and Quarry raised the roof. Cap'n A, Civil War was overstuffed. And Ghostbusters, man, was underpuffed. Bats and Suits was a rotten mess. Doctor Strange was good, I guess.
Deadpool's handing out Valentine's.
Ash vs. Evil Dead chilled our spines.
Independence Day made us frown. While the Get Down, man, it done got down. Louis Anderson, the best mom on TV. Star Trek celebrated the big 50. Great comic books from Marvel and DC. And Black Mirror got season 3.
We're pasty basement dwellers, pop culture Rockefellers. 2016's final frontier, so have a nerdy new year.
This year Saskatoon was cool as snow. Carrie Fisher came for Sask Expo. We got Bartari,
King Me,
Madibar.
Lots of cool joys to be a gaming czar. And we sure did get our anime on.
Town. There were two costumes for the Halloween, 11 and Harley Quinn. We still haven't found world peace, but we're closing out the year with Fantastic Beasts and Rogue One. How could I forget as we try to outrun the Imperial threat? 2017, we hope you're great. This time next year, we'll watch episode 8. So from all of us, the funkiest bunch, have a great new year. Love the
crew at Punch.
We're pasty basement dwellers, pop culture Rockefellers. 2016's final frontier, so have a nerdy new year.
Ow!
all right, baby. All right.
Hit the spot.
Punch TV is the nerdiest show in Saskatoon. If you like comics, movies, games, stellar events, and anything in geekdom, you'll love Punch TV. Host Jody Kaysen takes you in depth with artists, writers, and guests from across the province, the world, heck, even the galaxy. Plus, regular updates from The Collector, The Movie Geek, and Tweetbeat. Watch Punch TV only on Shaw TV.
At this time of year, we get together with families and friends to brighten each other's lives and cherish peace and goodwill. The Dragons Car Club wishes your family all the best the season and the new year have to offer. We hope to see you at our car show next spring.
This is the deal. You disobey me, you die. Try to escape, you die.
You got a boyfriend?
You irritate or vex me.
I'm known to be quite vexing. I'm just forewarning you.
You die.
If they get caught, we throw them under the bus.
What a ride!
If you're unconscious, you can't answer the simple questions that could save your life. Medic Alert speaks for you when you can't. Join today at medicalert.ca.
Welcome back, Saskatoon. We've got just under 7 minutes to the big top of the hour. We're super excited, and we got a lot to get done in the next 7 minutes. We got some crackers to pop and some hats to wear and champagne to pop and pour some glasses so we can cheer the new year. Whew, okay, so let's get it done. While I start to open the champagne, Tony, what's happening over at your table
I'm
there?
Standing over here with a table and we are getting ready to count down. It looks like we're almost at New Year's right now. 6 minutes to go and here I am. We've already talked to Dr. Strange a little bit.
That's
and
right.
He says that people really don't know who he is. So that's
I'm
good.
I'm okay with
You're
it.
All right? Yeah, that's good.
Recognition will come this year.
Yeah, exactly.
I feel it. It's on its way.
Okay, well, that's good, I guess.
You can't make noise, but, you know, getting out there.
Okay, well, there you go. And we're here with Superwoman.
No.
Oh, okay. And now we're here with Bat Lady.
Bat Girl.
All right. And do you mind if I call you Peter Parker? Oh, I blew that. Okay, well. Sorry. And of course, I'm just joking. I'm just joking. All right, Super Lady. What's what do you got going on? This is an exciting night for you. Are you gonna be like cruising around, flying around after this?
It's Supergirl.
Okay, Supergirl. Okay, yeah. Sorry, Supergirl. Yes.
No, I plan to hang around for a little while, keep an eye on Batman.
Yeah. Okay, Batman's over there. I don't know what he's got going on. I like that tick look he had earlier. Let's get that tick look going on, Batman. Let's do that. Okay. So now. There you go. The chick is back. Awesome.
We like to do some how-to on Punch TV, right? Yeah, there's a mic here. How handy.
Hey, Jody, can you tell us how you would crack open a bottle of premium champagne?
Yes, exactly. Don't look at the label too closely. Okay, so when you have champagne, you want to keep the bubbles in it, right? So you don't want to like shoot it off and like take out a light or an eye or whatever. So they come usually with these little cages, and sometimes they come off easily and sometimes they don't, but you just like unscrew the cage and loosen it up a little bit and then just grab the whole thing and then just turn it.
Whoa.
And just keep it so that it doesn't fly. Stay in the wine or non-alcoholic fruit beverage that it is, whatever it happens to be. But anyways, that's the best way to pop champagne so that it tastes good.
That was very smooth.
Thank you. It's not very showy. It doesn't have the spectaculari of like shooting off a cork, but...
But if you shoot off the cork, I mean, that's what happened to Nick Fury, and we all know how that ended up.
That's right. Okay, so be safe and be... savory. This is going to be good. This is a peach something or other. So I hope it's good. All right.
Safety first, kids.
All right. Let's get everybody to pop their crackers.
Ooh. Popping crackers?
Yeah.
I
guess so. If you guys want to pop some crackers. Crackers were always a tradition in my house for both Christmas and New Year's because, you know, we like wearing crazy hats and sometimes you get a good toy and usually you get like some kind of joke or something. So, okay. Do you want to... We always did it with somebody. So you, like the person beside you would grab an end together, like you do both at the same time. Yeah?
You Thor can go with you.
Okay.
I'll do it alone. Ready?
Okay, ready Thor? Go. Woo! Okay. Awesome. Okay. Ooh, I got a sticker. Okay. I'm gonna put my hat on.
Got a Christmas sticker.
These are always too big. But that one's not bad. That was nice. Brown. Aww. Oh, that'll be weird for you wearing a hat that's not your usual hat. Okay, did anybody get a joke?
Yeah, I got a joke.
Hey, what's your joke say?
Why can't you tell the joke to an egg?
Why can't you tell a joke to an egg?
Because it will crack up.
Wah, wah. Okay, my joke says, where is the ocean the deepest?
Where?
The bottom. Wah, wah. Okay, did you get a joke, Spidey?
Yes.
What's it say?
What did the magnet say to the other? I find you very attractive.
Aww. That's saucy. Oh, you've got one?
That's the best joke. What do you get between sunrise and sunset? Sunburned.
Oh. Wow. Oh, burn. Okay. You don't have your hat on yet, Tony.
No, I can't. I get all greasy and it's gross.
Okay. Thank you for sharing that with all of us for New Year's. Okay, let's get some glasses poured so we can... we're getting close. We're less than 2 minutes. Thank you, Thor. Do you do a lot of drinking on New Year's typically with your clan?
Oh, yeah, every day, too.
Oh, I like that. So that's not any different from any other day. Hmm. Does smell good. Are you going to put one on?
On Thor's hammer.
Can you lift that? Wow. Yeah, I know I can't lift that. Oh, I do like the stickers, though. Those are very festive. All right. We're down to 1 minute, 8, 7, 6, 5. I'm just practicing for when we actually hit the grand moment. We have a disco ball. Are you going to make it, like, slowly descend?
Yeah, we could have the ball drop. It's New Year's.
I forgot Dick Clark's cryogenically frozen head. I left him in the car. Well, we don't have time to get him, so, you know, sorry. This is our show now. This is our countdown. This has been an amazing year. I want to say a big thank you to the Justice League for coming down and celebrating with us. I know that, you know, you have your own peeps to be with, so for you to come down and share it with the people of Saskatoon, we appreciate that very, very much. And, of course, thank you to everybody out there who's tuned in and are counting down the precious few minutes of 2016. Not too sad to see 2016 go and looking forward to all the best
Nine,
in 2017.
Eight, seven, six,
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy New Year! All right. Well, thanks to all of you for tuning in. All the best to you and yours. And may 2017 bring you hope for. Happy New Year!
Down in the States, things aren't so good. Trump's moving into a worse neighborhood.
Boy!
Obituaries too long to list. Bigger than Denny's biggest breakfast. But we gotta give shout outs to Bowie and Prince and Willy Wonka's.